I've been was vegan for a very long time, and I've had to introduce fish and omegas into my life. My brain wasn't functioning properly. And I think that I was at one point pretty malnutrition.
So several people asked me to comment on the singer Miley Cyrus and her comments on omega-3 fats on the Joe Rogan podcast. Apparently this got millions of views and ruffled a lot of feathers. So let's take a look.
And I have to take all the things, omega, I was vegan for a very long time, and I've had to introduce fish and omegas into my life.
So what she's referring to there are long chain omega-3 fatty acids. When we eat fat, it contains these chains of carbon atoms, almost like children holding hands. The carbons are all connected to each other in a long row. Each blue circle there is a carbon, and this is ALA. It's an omega-3 fatty acid, and it's actually an essential fat. We need to get it from our food. So our body can take ALA and stretch the chain with more carbons and make longer fats, like EPA and DHA. So when people talk about fish and omega-3s, they're usually referring to the long chain omega-3 fatty acids, like EPA and DHA.
What did it do for your brain?
I feel that I'm much...
Slowed you down?
Now I'm so much sharper than I was.
Right, so that's a textbook anecdote. I changed something and this happened. It's impossible to establish causality. Is it possible that the dietary change has something to do with the perceived cognitive change? Sure, it's possible. This is actually an area of legitimate controversy. Some studies show improved cognitive function with EPA, DHA, omega-3 supplementation, and others show no effect, so it's not completely clear. It may be context dependent, it may be just in some people, so it's theoretically possible. On the other hand, is it possible that the perceived change in sharpness had nothing to do with the diet? Sure, it could have been any other change in her life. Sleep, exercise, stress, life events. Placebo effect, we know, is extremely robust, so it's impossible to establish causality to say if these facts are connected or not. Now, one obvious thing for anyone worried about their omega-3 levels is to measure them. There's kits for sale online. It costs like $50. But maybe she did that. Let's see.
I was running on empty.
Can I ask you, were you doing a vegan diet, like, meticulous?
The strictest you've ever known.
But were you doing intelligently? Like,
I
were
did
you
all
supplementing
my supplements,
the right way?
I do all my protein drinks. Mm-hmm. I've watched every bodybuilder's YouTube about how they still...
Right, so he's asking good questions. How did you do it? Because that's the question. And she goes to protein shakes and YouTube channels, which is a little odd. So things to bear in mind if somebody is going to go 100% plants, eat enough calories... are you going to focus on whole foods, whole plants instead of junk, vegan junk, right? Get a nice variety of different plants from the different groups, some legumes, some grains, some nuts and seeds, some other vegetables. So you get a nice balance of essential amino acids, get your B12, right? But she goes to protein shakes, which is a little odd because it's okay to get protein shakes if we want, but it's got nothing to do with omnivore versus vegan. Protein is not limiting on a vegan diet. So I'm not sure why that was the first thing that she went to. And then the first source of information she mentions, YouTube channels. I got nothing against YouTube channels, but that's your go-to for a health decision. I thought she was gonna say, if you have all the resources in the world, all the money in the world, I went to the top 3 registered dietitians in the nation. I hired a nutrition scientist to summarize all the literature for me. I mean, that's the type of thing I would do if I was a multimillionaire wanting to figure this out and had no background. In her defense, this is all off the cuff, and off the cuff is difficult. Every time I listen to myself on a podcast, I always think, I should have said this other thing, or I should have said that better or clearer. So she probably did many other things that she's not mentioning here.
That's what I'm saying. All of a sudden, I'm like, celery, and like, why are my thighs like...
Did she just say, all I eat is celery?
All I eat is celery.
I'm sure she's exaggerating, but this is what I mean. We see this often with ethical vegans, also with people who go vegan to lose weight. A lot of times, they'll get rid of the meat and dairy, and they'll just eat a small salad. And so if that's what she was trying to do, chances are she was hypocaloric. She was just not eating enough calories. And didn't she just say she had no energy, she was running on fumes?
I was running on empty.
So the first thing I would think of there is calories. Is she getting enough calories? Not omegas. Omegas would be like way down the list. It doesn't mean they couldn't possibly be low, but it's just kind of erratic. We should make these health decisions with some sense and some understanding and some high quality information, not like we're deciding what we're going to watch on Netflix. Just by the way, nutrition wise, this is not an issue. It sounds like she just added some fish. That's a very healthy dietary pattern. I wish she could influence more people in the U.S. to eat a lot of vegetables with some fish. Are you kidding?
Everybody's different. You know, we all have different ancestors, and our ancestors come from different parts of the world. And, you know, I don't know if the blood type thing is accurate, but some people really believe that.
So this is another thing that I like about seeing the brain, is I try to eat for my brain type and not my blood type necessarily. My brain type. So my brain type.
Okay, so this is getting a little off the rails, but the idea of the individual variability, there is legitimate variation from person to person in how much those short chain omega-3s get elongated to the long chain. Some people just do it better than others. So there are legitimate genetic differences, which he's alluding to. And it is possible that populations, ancient populations that ate more fish became worse elongators, worse converters, right? Because they were getting the long form EPA and DHA omega-3s from their diet. So they didn't need to convert, and vice versa. Populations that lived more inland or just didn't eat fish for some reason had to become genetically better elongators because they weren't getting it in their diet. So that's all possible. There are also environmental factors, high saturated fat and trans fats, ratio of omega-6 to omega-3s in the diet. All of that regulates, affects the efficiency of elongation. Tobacco also, and there's also some physiological adaptation there. The less of the long-form omega-3s we're getting in our diet, the more our enzymes will work to elongate them to supply that demand. So maybe she is a weak converter. If she was getting enough ALAs, enough short-form omega-3s in her diet, and if she was still low on long-form omega-3s, EPA and DHA, then she could be genetically a weak converter. And in that case, she could benefit from an exogenous, a dietary source. But that's a lot of ifs. We don't know what she was eating. Celery is not a good source of omega-3s. So maybe she'll give more details.
I'm experimenting a lot with like my diet. I think when you try all these different diets, like, okay, now I'm going to try keto. Now I'm going to try vegan. Mm-hmm. Now I'm going to try this. You're doing it at such a kind of, it's really hard to know what's affecting you. Right. So I tried to go slowly, like, okay, it takes a freaking long time, but going through and going, I'm going to eliminate this now. Right. And then I'm going to put it back and see how I feel.
Yeah, I hear this a lot. And I think this logic resonates with a lot of people. Just try different things and see how you feel. And it's intelligent to make small changes so you can identify potential causes instead of just jumping from trend to trend. But my main caveat there would be that if you're going 100% subjective, just see how I feel and what happens to my body, how do you know if your long-term risk of disease goes up or down? You don't. So you want a little bit of both. Of course, we all want to feel good in the moment, but you also want to know the long-term consequences. The main causes of disease and death in our society are not things you can just feel by trying. You can't feel your coronary starting to clog up. You can't feel your cancerous cells starting to multiply. It doesn't work that way. So you need some balance there. Otherwise, long-term, it's like flipping coins.
My body, when I am supplementing, especially with the omegas, like the omegas have really changed my life. And I was like so dry from having none of these healthy fats in my diet. Mm-hmm. I did what I could with like as many freaking avocados a day as I could have and other things, but it's hard to get the fat.
Yeah, that's a common idea. Avocado for the healthy fats, which it does have. Monounsaturated fats, omega-6s, but not omega-3s. Avocado is actually not a great source of omega-3 fatty acids. An entire avocado has 0.17 grams of ALA. Whereas just a tablespoon of ground flax seeds has 1.6 grams. So that's 10 times more in a much smaller volume. Here it is per ounce. You can get ALA from flax seeds, from walnuts, from chia seeds, and here's avocado, not in the same league. So she's right. There's only so much avocado you can eat, and it is hard to get some fats from there. That's not where you get your omega-3s. So maybe she just wasn't getting enough ALAs in the first place. Possible.
It's not as bioavailable.
And
when
your
like
brain
flax
is,
and
you know,
like
your.
Oh, he got it. He said flax seeds, right?
Your like brain is, you know, like your brain.
He's actually asking really good questions.
Your brain really needs those fats, and you know, it was really, really hard for me.
Fish oil is the way to go.
Yep.
I know people don't like it, and they don't like the idea behind it. But God damn it, it's so good for your brain.
Yeah.
Right. So dietary sources of long chain omega-3s. If you're a weak converter, or if you just want to play it safe, get a direct source of long chain omega-3s from your diet. You can eat fish. You can do the fish oil, like they're talking about. You can get it from algae, which is where the fish get it. There are algae supplements. There are also fortified foods with DHA, milks and others. The advantage of the algae, other than the ethics and the environment, which is fine, but nutrition-wise, they don't have the heavy metal contamination and other marine pollutants because they're grown in large tanks with no contamination from the sea. Other than that, all those sources listed above are effective. It's basically a personal choice. They've compared fish oil to algae supplements, and the algae were at least as effective. The authors even claim a bigger effect of the algae, but I don't think it was too convincing, and it was just one study, but it was clear that it was at least as effective as the fish oil. They've even compared algae supplements to salmon directly, not fish oil, but the actual fish, and they found the same bioavailability for those long omega-3 forms. So take your pick. They all appear equivalent for bioavailability. Also, if you eat farmed fish, the omega-3s often come from supplements because, of course, farmed fish are not fed algae. They're fed corn and soy like every other farmed animal nowadays, right? So those fish are also deficient in omega-3s, and the solution for the farmers has been to supplement. How ironic is it that the food people associate with omega-3s needs omega-3 supplements? Last point I want to make, the reaction to this video for a lot of people was, she's a singer, who cares, ignore her. Yes and no, she could be a singer and have great points on health or great information. But more than that, deciding which message we should believe based on the qualifications alone gets us in trouble. Because then an MD or someone else comes along and makes statements that are not evidence-based, and we all just nod because they should know. And we see this in nutrition all the time. And I get emails all the time from people saying, hey, I love your videos and I trust you. Don't. If the evidence I show is accurate, agree with it. If the evidence is inaccurate, disagree. Less trust and more asking for the evidence, and we'll all be better off. We got fish, we got fish oil, which is what they're talking about. We got fish, already said that. Also, people who go vegan for the weight loss. I need more omega-3s. Omega-3, 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 omega! Here's a complete look at how to do a plant-rich diet safely. Nutrients, supplements, pitfalls, everything. And here's more information on this self-experimentation issue and what problems to avoid.